morning to you. Give us a king. 1 Samuel chapter 8 and verse 6. But the thing displeased Samuel when they said, give us a king to judge us. And Samuel prayed unto the Lord. Verse 7. And the Lord said unto Samuel, hearken unto the voice of the people in all that they say unto thee. For they have not rejected thee, but they have rejected me, that I should not reign over them. God has a marvelous sense of respect for man's will that really baffles me. I must confess that as a father, I do not have that restraint and all that respect for my children exercising their will. I'm thinking that if it is bad for them, they will not have it, full stop. But God does not operate that way as he operates with us adults. God bows. This may sound strange, but God bows to man's will. And this is the same reason why some people will be lost. Because many times what they want to do is not the correct thing for them. But God does not just tell them no. He allows them to exercise their power of choice. Look at the case in point. The nation of Israel is being run by God. We call that the theocracy. God is giving the instruction and the prophet or priest carrying it out and the nation following. But here they look at the surrounding nations and they concluded that they wanted a king like the surrounding nations. When Samuel heard that, he felt bad in that he is saying, well, it is because my sons, they are not judging well. But God said, no, it's not just about that. They're just using that as a ploy. But the real thing is that they have rejected me. And then, listen, then God answers their request by showing Samuel to anoint Saul. Now, God has a sense of humor too. God gave them what they want. If God had given them a short king, most likely they would have said no. But he gave them Saul, King Saul, who is tall and towering above the others. In other words, the outward appearance of the king is what they were focusing on. Not the integrity or the moral uprightness, just the outward appearance like the other nations. And they say, yay, that is what we want. Further, listen to this. God told Samuel to explain to them the hardship that the king will cause them to pass through. How he will take the maidens and the young men to be soldiers, including. But yet they said, that is what we want. In spite of that, they say, we still want a king. So this is showing us very clearly that as human beings, we do not know exactly what we want. So the best way to make a request of God, please listen to me, the best way to make a request of God is when you would have made that request and you think it's a sensible request. Ask God to give it to you if he, God, who knows the future, knows that that is a request that will benefit us materially and spiritually, then let him give it to us. If, therefore, you put it that way and God says no, don't give up on God. He knows, he sees past, present, future. Don't give up on him. And please understand that when you agree to subject your will to God's will, thy will be done, then at the end of the day, you can be very comfortable in knowing that what God has given to me is what will be beneficial to me because I allow God to make the final choice. Today, you may be shouting, God give me this, God give me that, and you don't get it, and you get vexed. No, calm down, calm down. Look at the history of the kings. Look at the ways they led Israel astray, which was actually showing that the theocracy, God leading them, is the way they should have continued. Our God and Father, thank you so much for showing us that our selfish desires, when we try to satisfy those selfish desires, it will give us problems. Help us to pray and to depend upon you for the final decision. Guide us throughout the day, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. May God richly bless you.
As fair as the day that blesses my soul with love, the way that he loves is a song.